Hi guys, welcome to Electrical Project channel. Recently I bought my favorite IRF-540N MOSFETs. The only problem with them, they are the fake ones. I must admit that these fake MOSFETs work, and in some cases you will not even notice any difference. But the difference in fact is big, and that is what I'm gonna show you. Here I have one real and one fake MOSFET. As you can see, both of them have IRF-540N written on them, but one of them is fake. To show the difference between real and fake MOSFETs, I'll take some measurements, and then I'll calculate drain to source on resistance. In order to take measurements, we'll need a 12V DC power supply, a 12V light bulb, and a multimeter to measure current and voltage. Let's measure the current first. We'll need this information later. So we have 1.75 amperes. Now I'll show you that it's actually 12 volt. Well, it's 12.2 volts. I'll measure the voltage drop for each MOSFET when they are on. And since we also know the current, we can calculate drain to source on resistance and compare it to the datasheet. So let's do it. First, we need to connect probes to drain and source leads. And nothing happens. Well, that is because the MOSFET is off. We need to touch gate lead in order to turn it on. And now we have our first measurements, 0.12 volts. Well, great, let's do it for the other MOSFETs. And we have 0.16 volts. And here we have 0.16 volts as well. And the last fake MOSFET. And we have 0.16 volts here as well. Now let's compare to the real IRF-540N MOSFETs. And here you can see the real difference. We have 0.05 volts. Good MOSFET. Let's try one more real MOSFET. And we have 0.05 volts as well. Now let's use Ohm's law to calculate on resistance. In order to do so, we need to divide our measurements by current. In our case, the current is 1.75 amperes. We measured it earlier. And here are the results. Now let's compare this to the datasheet. And as you can see, the real MOSFETs show even better results than in datasheet. And the fake MOSFETs are way off. What does this mean? Well, it means that in some applications, these fake MOSFETs will generate much more heat than intended. About 2 times more heat. But I'm pretty sure that if you measure other specs of these fake MOSFETs, they are not okay as well. So it means that many devices simply fail to work with these fake MOSFETs. Another problem, that we even don't know what specs these fake MOSFETs really have. And that is all for this comparison. Thanks for watching, see you next time!